आई एम संतोष गैदनकर. टुडे आई एम टीचिंग यू मैकेनिक्स ऑफ मटेरियल इन दैट वन वॉल्यूमेट्रिक स्ट्रेन. जनरलाइज हुक्स लॉ. आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम बेस्ड अपॉन द जनरलाइज हुक्स लॉ. ए बार ऑफ 600 mm लॉन्ग हैविंग ए स्क्वायर सेक्शन ऑफ साइज 50 x 50 mm एन एक्सियल लोड ऑफ 120 kN एंड लैटरल कॉम्प्रेसिव लोड ऑफ 600 kN. द लैटरल कॉम्प्रेसिव लोड ऑफ 600 kN ऑन द फेस ऑफ 50 x 600 mm. फाइंड द चेंज इन साइज. दैट मीन्स यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द चेंज इन साइज एंड वॉल्यूम. यंग्स मॉडुलस एंड पॉइसन्स रेशियो दे हैव गिवन इट. ए स्क्वायर सेक्शन इज देयर. स्क्वायर सेक्शन इज प्रोवाइडेड हियर. स्क्वायर सेक्शन इज 50 mm. इफ ए बार इज सब्जेक्टेड टू एन एक्सियल 120 kN एंड लैटरल 120 दे हैव गिवन इट. 120 kN. नेक्स्ट लैटरल कॉम्प्रेसिव लोड ऑफ 600 kN ऑन द फेसेस ऑफ 50 mm टू 600 mm. दैट मीन्स ए कॉम्प्रेसिव लोड इज गिवन हियर लैटरल. दैट मीन्स 600 kN and 600 kN they have given it. And the length for this is 600 mm. This is L, this is W, and this will be thickness. Now this part I will consider as a X, this one is Y, and this one is Z. Find the change in size. We have to find out the change in size. Change in terms of change in size nothing but you have to find out delta T, delta W and delta L. And simultaneously you have to find out volume, delta V. Finding or data given, delta W we have to find out, delta T we have to find out and delta L, delta V. Young's modulus is given as 2 × 10⁵ Newton per mm square. 1 by m or mu is equal to 0.3. Now, we know that in order to find out volumetric strain, change in volume, we know the formula. Volumetric strain is equal to sigma x plus sigma y plus sigma z divided by E 1 minus 2 mu. First, I'm going to split the formula. Now, what is sigma x? Sigma x is nothing but Px divided by Ax. What is P? 600. X direction, this is the X. 600 × 10³. What is the area? Area is nothing but this is the area. 600 into thickness. Thickness here is given 50 mm. 600 × 50. It is 20 N/mm². But it is in compressive in nature. Compressive. Sigma y, py divided by ay. What is py? Py 600 × 10³. What is the area? Area is nothing but 600 into distance, 50. 600, that means this length will be 600 into 50. 600 into 50. Again, 20 N/mm². It is compressive based upon the direction. Next, sigma z is equal to Pz divided by Az. 120 × 10³. What is the area? This is the area. 50 × 50. Answer is 48 N/mm². This is in tensile. Now substitute these values here. You will get EV value. EV is equal to, what is sigma x? Minus 20. It's compressive. What is sigma y? Minus 20 plus 48 tensile divided by 2 into 10 raised to 5, 1 minus 2 into 0.3. Therefore, EV is nothing but 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 5. What is EV? This is the value. Now, what is EV? EV is nothing but delta V by V. What is volume? 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 5 delta V. Volume is nothing but thickness into W into L. 50 into 50 into 600. Cross multiply, delta V will be 24 mm cube. It is a volume. Volume has to be expressed in terms of mm cube. Volume has to be expressed in terms of mm cube. Now we have to find out delta L. In the earlier cases, we used to find out the delta L by formula EV is equal to delta L by L into 1 minus 2V. Because it is a variable in that formula. Therefore, we have to find out the strain. Now strain EX is nothing but, this is the formula, sigma X divided by E, 1 minus sigma Y divided by ME, 1 minus, that is the formula we have derived it in the volumetric strain. Now, as per this diagram, the formula will changes. Now X becomes what? As per this diagram, it is a compressive in nature, minus X divided by E and Y, minus of minus it becomes plus sigma Y divided by ME, and Z, it is in tensile but here negative sign, keep as it is. Substitute the values. What is sigma X? Minus 20 divided by Young's modulus, 2 into 10 raised to 5, plus sigma Y, 20 divided by, what is 1 by? 1 by M is nothing but mu into 0.3 divided by 2 into 10 raised to 5 minus, what is sigma Z? 48 into 0.3, 1 by M is equal to mu divided by 2 into 10 raised to 5. If you calculate this value, the answer is minus 1.42 into 10 raised to minus 4. We got strain here, strain along the x axis, along the x. As the force is implement over this phase, the dimension W will be decreases. The effect in the dimension W will be occurs. As the force act over this surface, the dimension W will be reduced. Therefore, divided by W. That means change in length or change in width divided by original width. Because this is in compressive nature, I have to focus. As it is compresses, this dimension will alter. Now we have to find out delta W. This is, we know, minus 1.42 into 10 raised to minus 4 is equal to delta W into 50. Therefore, delta W is nothing but minus 7.1 into 10 raised to minus 3. Minus indicate decrease. Now, I have to solve for delta T. Delta T and delta L. Now in case of Y, strain in case of Y, EY is nothing but, the actual formula is sigma Y divided by E minus sigma X divided by ME minus sigma y divided by ma, sigma z divided by ma. This is the actual formula in the derivation we have obtained. Now, as per the diagram, the sigma y is compressive in nature. Therefore, you have to write minus sigma y divided by e. Sigma x is also in compressive in nature. Therefore, minus minus become plus sigma x divided by me. This is in tensile, but there is a negative sign. You have to keep as it is, sigma z divided by me. Now, substitute the value. What is sigma y? Minus 20. It is 20. It becomes minus 20 divided by 2 into 10 raised to 5 plus sigma x 20 into 0.3. 20 into 0.3 divided by 2 into 10 raised to 5 minus 48 into 0.3 divided by 2 into 10 raised to 5. 2 into 10 raised to 5. If you calculate, the answer will be minus 1.42 into 10 raised to minus 4. EY value. This is decreases. Now, our intention is to find out EY is nothing but, now, if a force is applied as per the direction, which dimension is going to change? Here, T will alter. Here, because of this compression, the T get reduced. Therefore, delta T by T. Already we know EY value 1.42 into 10 raised to minus 4. Delta T, what is the original T? 50. Cross multiply. Delta T is equal to minus 7.1 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm. Minus indicate decrease. Now last is strain. In sigma z, the formula for sigma z as per the derivation, sigma z divided by e minus sigma x divided by me minus sigma y divided by me. Now as per the diagram, the sigma is positive, sigma z divided by e, sigma y will be compressive, therefore positive, sigma x divided by me, similarly y is also compressive, positive, negative negative becomes positive, sigma y divided by me. Now substitute the value, sigma z is nothing but 48 into 2 into 10 raised to 5 Young's modulus plus 20 into 0.3 divided by 2 into 10 raised to 5 plus 20 divided by 10 raised to 5. If you calculate, the answer is 3 into 10 raised to minus 4. Ez is equal to, we know that, delta L divided by L. Now, as per the diagram, if tension is applied, the length increases. It affects the length. Therefore, delta L by L. What is L? L is nothing but 600. Right here. 3 into 10 raised to minus 4, delta L divided by 600. Cross multiply, delta L will be 0.18 mm. In this way, you have to find out the change in width, change in thickness, and change in length when the diagram is mutually perpendicular to each other. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.